Ya وجيه والكرم وحليف العلم والحكم.
Clothes, everything. Okay, and from here also, pants, everything, just removing. And normally they give you in each single masjid where they do the equipments of the janaza, they have gloves. So you put on a gloves on your left hand normally, okay? Because you will be using the shower by your right hand, okay? So now it is ready to go. After taking off the clothes, yeah, so it just comes off. What do you do? After taking off everything, so any earring, necklace, or for example the rings, etc., you remove them all, and then you just give a normal wudu. Keep in your mind, in our time, it's very fashionable, okay, to put in a cotton in the mouth and nose and the ears. Why? Just to avoid the water from these areas. But we do not do it. Okay. So what do we do? So after, when body is ready, we give wudu. Okay, first washing the palm up to the wrist, another one, okay, and then washing the face, okay, and then arms first, right, second, left. After that, you wet your hand, you make a masah on the head, on here, okay, and then ears, okay, and the last thing is the feet. Okay, first, right one, washing, and then the left one, again washing. Okay, so now wudu is perfectly performed. What do we do now? We start giving ghusl. Normally, first thing in the ghusl, what do we wash? It's our head. Okay, the water that you will be using, initially it used to be like a water with some certain powder. They would put the powder, and then they would boil the water. Not boiling, but just to heat up. Warm water for the dead body. But now they do not do it, but they use the shower. Just normal tap water. We say, make it warm and wash, no problem. Okay? So, after performing the wudu, then you wash the head. Okay, everything on the head. Okay, so you wash it three times. Okay, and after that, after the head, what do? We wash our right shoulder when we make ghusl amara. So same thing about the dead body. So you will put the body on the left side so you can wash the right side. Okay, so it will look like this. You know, with the brothers it's more serious, because when it fell off with the ladies, they laughed properly, you know. So now we are laughing, it's not because this fell off, but because they did laugh. So we are laughing on them, you know? So we are better. We are better all the time, you know? So after that, so then you wash from the right shoulder. Okay? What is the aim? The aim is so you see that water is going all over the body and dropping on the table. Okay, so you will wash it from both of the sides. Okay? And also keep in your mind that underneath of the hands, you have to wash there also. You will be wearing a gloves, okay? As well as a belly button, okay? So inside, as well as from the back, okay? Underneath of the, for example, legs, okay? You will be wearing a gloves, okay? And normally what happens, you can come to help me, because when you will be washing the private place, what happens? Are you scared? I'm scared.
Just hold the cloth.
Yeah. Just hold it there. And wash feet. Are you scared? Okay, just hold it there. So, just lift it. So, bring it to this place. So, they will be holding it there, so I cannot see the aura. But shower will go underneath, and my hand is there also. So, I will just give a ghusl from underneath, okay? Just washing all of the places. So, that's it. Put it back. And then I will wash the...
Do you use soap?
Sorry?
Do you use soap?
No. Normally, no. Normally, there will be powder. It was...
Azam.
No, it was not Azam. It was this. Mist. So then you just wash the legs and toes, both. Okay, both of them. Okay, so now right side is done.
Yeah. Would you touch it?
No, with the left hand. From the right side is finished, so you just turn over the body. Okay, so you just bring it back. Yeah, so I hope that with the janaza, his hand doesn't fall off. So you just, if it falls off, you just put it back like that. Yeah. Okay, so that same procedure from the left side. Washing, so you have to make sure that water is everywhere and then drops on the table. Okay, from there also. So you just apply that. Okay, up to the toes. Okay, and after doing it, now ghusl is finished. What do? We just lift the body slightly. Okay, you just lift the body slightly. So. Body can just sit up slightly, not properly, but just slightly, just moving like that. And then after that, you just wipe the tummy, belly, but not very strong, but slowly, gently. It's just to make sure that if there is anything, like urine or etc., it just will come out. Okay, and if anything comes out, no worries, do not repeat the ghusl, but only that area. Just you will wash here, there, and that's it. Now, ghusl is finished. We use the towel just to wipe the body, just to dry off the body. And after that, we, before putting into the kafan, we just bring the kafur. Kafur is a perfume of a dead people. Normally, they do offer it in the masjid. Do you know the kafur, the artificial kafur that we use in the toilets also to kill the smell? Kafur is very well known, like a smell. So you just put it on the places of sajda. So it is forehead, nose, okay, and then palms, both of the palms from inside, okay, both of the knees, and then feet, okay, kafur. Just to make sure that the insects will not finish off the person. So it is just respected places. Now this is done.
Can I just ask you, is the kafur is made of any perfume or anything?
Sorry?
The kafur is made of any perfume?
No, kafur is a plant actually. They melt, they crush it, and they make it into the perfume. Yeah, I didn't understand, but it's right.
That's what I said.
So that's finished, inshallah. Okay, so now the body is ready. So then, what do? So body will be just in the desk. Okay, the washing desk, and there will be another desk in which we will have the fabrics. Okay, the kafan. Okay, so inshallah I'm going to apply it in the same place. So body will be still laying in the same place. Yes, please. It may fall off. Okay, now what do we have here? We have kafan. So before using the kafan, if you remember, we do use a bakhur, agarwood. Okay, so what do? We smoke the agarwood and then we make sure that the kafan will be perfumed with it. Okay, all of the places, we just smoke it, everything, all of the kafans. Okay, and then we place the kafan on the table, on the same order, I mean opposite order, by which we put on them. Okay, so the last one is going to be lifafa, and before that izar, and before that is going to be qamis. Okay, lifafa and izar is the tallest one, so it is from the head up to the toes. Qamis is from the shoulders up to the toes. Okay, so how do we do? So we put the in opposite order. So the thing which will be rolled off first will be laid down as last. Okay, so it is just technical thing. So the first thing is a lifafa. Lifafa, what do we do with the lifafa? Lifafa will be rolled up as a last. Okay, so here is the lifafa. And the next is qamis. What is the izar, sorry. What is the izar? Izar is again from the head up to the toes. So here is the here is the izar. And the last thing is going to be a qamis. Qamis from the shoulder up to the toes. If you remember, I did mention that there are two ways of doing qamis. One is the most common way, exactly the same one, you just put it on top of him, and the second way is doing it as like puncho. Do you remember Mexican? Sorry? Yeah, so so it will be like that, but they make a hole for the head in there. Is it from me?
Okay.
Is it again? I have no more mobile there. Okay, so qamis will be just, we make a hole on that. Okay, but that is not very often performed. Okay, and the most common way is just to make it as the rest of them. So it's going to be from the qamis up to the from the qamis up to the toes. So here is the last bit performed. Now, you want to add something?
How would you see if we make the qamis double way?
Yeah.
So for example now. So just place like where the shoulder comes, up to the shoulder, just place the cloth, and well, there will be obviously hair hole for head go through, then we just keep this cloth like on this end, right, after we lying the body here, then we take this one over the head.